CaseyOxen.MMA Inside the Cage. I'm here with Leo Vieira, possibly the most dynamic grappler that has ever lived. You're here tonight with Demian Maia. Talk a little bit about that fight. I'm sure you're absolutely ecstatic to see him get the win so quickly.
Yeah, like actually he was doing exactly what we prepped. We know the guy was like a tall. We know the guy's very good at judo, and we was planning to take the control of the octagon, go to the clinch, work the tank down, but not to take the guy down, but to go to the back. And as soon as the first opportunity he get, he went to the back and he worked his tank down. And we was lucky, like kind of lucky, because when they take him down, he was knocking down and was fast.
Nice, nice. Now, anybody that knows anything about jiu-jitsu knows your dominance in the sport of jiu-jitsu at the Abu Dhabi. You were multiple time champion. Talk about your evolution into mixed martial arts. You mentioned that your brother is teaching at AKA. Talk about your inclusion in that.
Yeah, I think Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and MMA, they work together, they walk together, I think we have you can choose many fights to strike. You have boxing, Muay Thai, make many different styles. You have a different style to taking down, judo, wrestling, anything. But Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is the only fight make you... You learn how to, you keep your back on the floor and fight with your back on the floor. So this is most important, so everybody has to practice jiu-jitsu. And I think what me and my brother and some guys, we just we understand about it's kind of similar, but it's very different. The distance is very different. So we made a lot of changes we understand BJJ, it's one kind of style, one kind of distance, one kind of timing. Then we have submission, then you have MMA. So when you realize it's three different fights, but it's very similar, then it's okay. Then you really understand. It's like when you speak Spanish and Portuguese. Right. It's very similar, but it's totally different. You know, so you cannot use one language and another, because you're gonna be confused. So that's what we doing.
Nice. Now, you of course you've been in the sport for many, many years. From what I've heard, anybody that's ever been on the mat with you says you're ultra dangerous. I mean, these are guys that are at the high level. Guys like Robert Drysdale, huge guys, and who never believed that a guy of your size could do to them what you've done to them. Have you ever considered making a switch and going into mixed martial arts yourself?
Like, I saw a lot of students come training and go. Of course, I think about it so much, and of course it was when I was young, but my life when I really wants to fight, and actually I training, I went there once, and I couldn't fight because the opponent wasn't there, and I get sorry, because I wish. But then we have a problem inside the team. That's when we split the team, and was kind of, I get a lot of responsibility that time to run the team, checkmate. So then with so much responsibility, then I couldn't work in my, I have to take care of all my students. Then I couldn't spend my time myself to compete and fight. And that's why I was a distance. Now, I don't know, maybe I'm too old, or maybe I think if we have too much young people, very good. And then I have so many fighters, but I never get a good opportunity. If I get, yeah, I will.
Very, very nice. Okay, real quick, this is a huge night for Brazil. Of course, there was a lot of talk with Chael Sonnen here at the main event, talking a lot of talk about Brazil. Some people say it's hype. Some of the Brazilians took it to heart. What is your take on this, and who is your pick for the fight this evening?
Yeah, I pick Anderson. For sure, it's not only because of all the things, but I think he's very talented. He's a how he work, how amazing. He's amazing. His fight, and not only because he's Brazilian, but I think Chael Sonnen, he talks too much. I'm a guy who I'm traveling around the world many times, and what make me feel welcome in every place where I go, it's and I go to different culture. You have to know about how you treat people, and especially because, doesn't matter how many times you're gonna win this thing, you know, people will forget, you know, and what is what people will remind, it's about your reputation, you know. I believe he's a kind of nice guy, but I think he tried to promote so much his fight, and he just he crossed a little bit the line about Brazil or culture, or you know, like it's so many people doesn't they, you know, so many Brazilian there, they couldn't anything, they live in that system, that his land, that his life, and they are and we are so proud what about what we have. And of course, man, it's a we be all the Brazilians would be like screaming on Anderson Silva tonight.
So what is your take, like as far as, you know, give me how, when, and where tonight, how Anderson Silva takes this fight?
I think Anderson Silva, he's gonna, like, he goes to, like, for the least first, second round. Yeah. I think he goes, because he always studied the guy from the first round. I think another angle, if you see another angle, Chael Sonnen is very smart, because if he try to break his mind, you know, Anderson Silva's mind, and make Anderson Silva, you know, like a come and if he Anderson Silva put his heart in front of your mind, then maybe he gonna get an opportunity. But if he Anderson Silva do it exactly what he always do, study the guy, just see what happened in the first round, then come to, you know, to do what I have to do in the second. So he keep his strategy. It's a for sure he's gonna win.
Well, there you have it. Casey Oxendow here with the legendary Leo Vieira, right here with MMA Inside the Cage.